Hello everyone, welcome to ITLS Academy. Our lecture is Pus Culture and Sensitivity Test. First of all, we will see what is pus. Pus from wound, burns and sinuses. So we are going to discuss pus culture and sensitivity. First of all, we will see pus. First point is, pus is surgically obtained pus or fluid. Pus is better than swabs. Tissue in small amounts of saline. Aspirates from closed abscess. These four points are related to pus. If anaerobes suspected, then first point, ask for and inoculate in anaerobic transport medium, bag tea and alert bottles. Next one, immediate transport. Aim of the test or aim of the pus culture. First point is isolate and identify aerobic and anaerobic pathogenic organisms, pus specimen. The aerobic pus culture test is performed to detect a bacterial infection at a wound and identify the bacteria causing it so that the wound can be treated properly. The pus culture test is performed when a wound shows signs of an infection where the wound does not heal. We can say that if it is a wound and if it is not healed, then there will be an aqueous culture, a jelly-like something, and that particular jelly-like thing is known as pus. It becomes red, swollen and tender and start to drain fluid or pus. This unhealed wound will start to release or start to drain pus. The test is done on a sample of pus to identify the presence of the pathogenic organism in the pus. A culture of a sample is done to find germs, bacteria or fungus present in it. A sensitivity test is done to check what kind of medicines like antibiotics will inhibit the growth of the organism and help in treating the infections. For pus culture, a sample of pus is added to a substance which promotes the growth of microorganisms. If no microorganism grow, the culture is said to be negative. On the other hand, if the microorganisms that can cause infection to grow The culture is said to be positive. The type of microorganisms may be identified by a microscope or chemical test. Bacteria will usually grow quickly in a culture in approximately 2 days, while other types of microorganisms like fungus can take longer. A culture and sensitivity test can be done on other body fluids too. Types of specimen. The point is, swabs from the infected area or aspiration from deep wounds. Swabs in anaerobic transport media for the isolation of anaerobes. These are types of specimen. Criteria of specimen resection. It includes inappropriate specimen transport device, mislabeled specimen, unlabeled specimen, dried samples, and specimen received after prolonged delay, usually more than 72 hours. Specimen received in expired transport media. These are some criteria of specimen resection. Here it is a list of pathogens and their commensals present in particular culture. So in the case of pus infection, it is a list of pathogenic bacteria and this is a list of commensals bacteria. So Pseudomonas aeruginosa is pathogenic bacteria and its commensals bacteria is alpha hemolytic streptococci. Next pathogenic bacteria is Proteus species and its commensals flora is Cornibacterium species. Next pathogenic bacteria is E. coli and its commensals flora is Coagulase negative staphylococci. Next pathogenic bacteria is Klebsiella species and its commensals bacteria include Propionibacterium species. Next pathogenic bacteria is Morganella and its commensals bacteria is Bacillus species. Next pathogenic bacteria list is given, but it is without commensals bacteria. So let's see what are pathogenic bacteria without commensals bacteria. First one is Providencia. Next is Streptococcus pyogenes. Next one is Staphylococcus aureus. Another pathogenic bacteria is Enterococcus species. Next one is Clostridium perfringens. Another bacteria is Fusobacterium species. Next one is Streptococcus species. Next pathogenic bacteria is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. We also know that Mycobacterium tuberculosis is the causing agent of tuberculosis or TB. Next one is Nocardia species. And last but not least is Actinomyces israelii. These are list of pathogenic bacteria which can cause infection in pus. Some of the bacteria are given with their commensal flora. Let's come to the pre-specimen processing. Pre-specimen processing include pus and wound swab specimen collection. You can see these are the instruments for the collection of swab and pus. You can see that this is cotton swab. Cotton is wrapped all around it, and from this device pus can be collected. This is rounded shaped cotton swabs, and from this particular sample can be collected. This you can see is container like thing. In this particular container this specimen is stored. So, first point in pus and wound swab specimen collection is no touching technique, and this technique remove bandage with the forceps. Point 2 is with the forceps take a sponge, dip it in the saline and wash the surface of the wound or ulcers. Next point in sample collection include remove the swab from its covering and extend the tip of the swab deep into the wound, taking care not to touch the adjacent skin margins. So there must be a proper care taken. If someone is taking sample, then this particular needle, particular swab must be dipped directly to wound. It must not be touched any margins. Fourth step in a specimen collection is remove the stopper from the test tube with transport medium. Plunge the swab into the transport medium and replace the stopper. This is process of collection of specimen. You can see how the collection of specimen is done from the parts. Specimen commonly collected for the diagnosis of vaginitis, vaginosis or uterine sepsis is high vaginal swab. You can see this is stopper is here, and this is swab like structure, cotton swab. The swab is inserted into upper part of the vagina. It depends from where from which side the sample is taken and rotated therefore before withdrawing it. Here some points regarding a specimen of collection is given. You can see pus from abscess is best to collect at that time the abscess is incised and drained. using sterile technique aspirate or collect from drainage tube up to 5 milliliter of pus transfer to sterile container. Next point is, if pus is not being discharged, use sterile cotton wool swab to sample from the infected site. Extend the swab deeply into the depth of the lesion. Immerse the swab in container of transport medium. Label it and send to the laboratory as soon as possible. Next point is, samples of pus are preferred to swabs. However, pus swabs are often received. When using swabs, the deepest part of the wound should be sampled, avoiding the superficial microflora. Swabs should be well soaked in pus. Swabs for bacterial and fungal culture should be placed in the transport medium provided in the tube. Pus aspiration specimen collection. This is how pus is taken from the surface of hand. Needle is inserted into skin lesion. You can see this is a particular wound. Needle is inserted over here. Here no touch from the margin. In this pic, in the second pic, you can see here also no any connection with margin is done. By inserting a needle within a skin lesion, fluid or pus can be aspirated and sent to the laboratory for examination. Here it must be sure that what quantity of specimen should be taken. So specimen sufficient amount on swab or aspiration in transport media or syringe. Time relapse before processing the sample. So the time relapse is 30 minutes. Next comes storage. Maintain specimen swab at room temperature. Do not refrigerate. Specimen processing. Media includes blood agar, chocolate agar, McConkie agar, and thioglycolate broth. Culturing procedure includes streak one blood agar plate, one chocolate, McConkie, and inoculate thioglycolate broth tube. Gram stain to check the presence or absence, and if present, the type or types and the predominant organisms. Hmm. You can see here culturing process. First of all, we will see the wound or abscess. From the wound, sample is taken and this sample is Gram stained. After Gram staining, this culture is processed in four medias. The media include blood agar, chocolate agar, McConkey agar, and thioglycolate. Post specimen processing. Interfering factors are patient on antibiotic therapy. And next interfering factor is improper sample collection. Result reporting. First point is report Gram stain findings as an initial report. Next point is report the isolated pathogens and its sensitivity pattern as a final report. Turn around time. First point is Gram stain results should be available 1 hour after specimen receipt. Next point is isolation of a possible pathogen can be expected after 2 to 3 days. Negative culture will be reported out 1 to 2 days after the receipt of the specimen. Some additional information regarding the pus culture test is given. Additional information is contamination of the specimen with normal flora is one of the major obstacles in obtaining good results. If some specimen is collected and these are cultured, these are the bacteria, virus or other specimen, if this is normal, then it will result in proper results. Result will be proper and result will be good. While if this is infected or this is not properly taken, then it will be it is contaminated by any mean, then it will not show good result. So we can say that specimen collection should be proper and it must not be contaminated, because contamination is one of the major obstacles in obtaining good results. Care should be taken to avoid contaminating the specimen with normal flora. There must be proper care in obtaining the specimen from the person, because if there is any contamination with normal flora, that is it can be from skin, like if someone is taking sample from this particular site, so it is said that there must not be any contact with margins, because In margin, there is normal flora of the skin or that particular site is present. So if there will be any contact with this margin, then this particular site's normal flora will interfere with these microorganisms that are collected in this specimen. So to avoid any contamination, the care should be taken so that there is no any normal flora present in a specimen, because the specimen because any normal flora contamination can also result in rejection of a specimen. Proper care of contaminants could be accomplished by swabbing superficial infected wounds with 70% alcohols. As we know that alcohol is a agent that can kill microorganisms, so if there is application of 70% alcohol nearby the infected site, there is less chances of contamination. Thank you guys for watching this session. You can follow ITLS Academy on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WhatsApp and on LinkedIn. Guys, you can subscribe ITLS Academy for latest updates and latest videos. You can also get app of the ITLS Academy from the YouTube, so that you can easily access all the informations, all the new updates directly and easily. Thank you for watching. You can like, share and subscribe ITLS Academy. And for any help or query, you can call us on 7080833450, or you can reach us on www.itlsacademy.com. Thank you very much again for watching this particular session. We will continue our more test in our next lecture.